Welcome back to the channel. My name is Tronage, and today we're going to be talking about flying as a form of therapy for, you know, mental health. Stay tuned. Alright, so here we are in the car, and as you may or may not know, this is my cousin over here. His name's Lorenzo. I don't know if he's been on the channel yet or not, depending on when I post this video, but essentially the relationship is my mom and his mom are sisters, and our grandfather, basically our parent, our mom's dad. There will be a test at the end of this, so make sure you pay attention to the family heritage. Passed away. He actually died on January 20th, 2018. So, not too long ago. It was a tough time for us. But what we decided was to get our minds off of everything that was going on. We wanted to just do some flying and get in some hang time. So, quite literally, what was it? The day after? The day after he died, I said, hey, you know, do you want to go do some flying? He's like, heck yeah. So we did some flying, and you know what? It helped. Because when you're flying and you're in that groove, you're just thinking about your flying. You're not thinking about, you know, who died. You're not thinking about your girlfriend broke up with you. You're not thinking about you lost your job. You know, whatever is going on in your life, kind of can't think about that stuff because your main focus is trying to keep a craft up in the air and flying. And it kind of took all the sadness. I wouldn't say it took it away, but it was a good distraction is what I would say. And that's the message I'm just wanting to give you guys on this vlog while we're on our way to fly, is that, you know, if you have some rough times going on in your life, maybe go out and fly. Get some fresh air. And it clears out your mind. Let you, you know, focus on what's at hand. And also there's camaraderie. You know, I'm here with my cousin. You may have whoever you go out and fly with. And they can be part of your support system. Even if they don't fly, maybe just be like, hey, you know, Joe Schmo or whoever, I want to go do this thing. I'm going to do some flying. I know you don't fly, but why don't you just come and keep me company? And what you'll find is it helps because you're spending time with some people. They're helping support you in what you're doing. And it gets you through that rough time and into some good stuff, you know? So don't be afraid that, you know, just get outside and do something. Get some people together and get some flying. What do you think? What's your story?
I think it's a great idea. I just wouldn't be going crazy if something sad happened, because then if something breaks on your quad, it's not going to get any better.
That's a very good point. Notice what I said was fly. I didn't say go crazy doing tricks. Just cruise. Just take it easy. Take it, you know, slow. Just drive. Pretend, you know, back to basics. Just work on casual flying and not doing crazy stuff because, yeah, like you said, if you break your quad in a crash, now you're going to be extra angry or cranky or sad or whatever the case is. So, yeah, take it easy. That's a good point. Any other thoughts? Because that was a good gem.
That's a good one.
I like it.
That's all I got.
That's all you got?
Yeah, I think so.
That's it? See you.
That's pretty much
done. All right. Cool. Well, at least it was a gem, so.
Yeah, at least it was a good one.
It was a good one. All right, so we're just about at our flying spot. So today I have really no agenda for flying other than I'm going to fly. Got my HGLRC XJB 145 ready to go. Got a whole bunch of packs. Got my tune on. I'm pretty sure I like my tune for the 4S now. So if I feel like there's anything weird that I want to change on it, maybe I'll play with that a little bit. But I'm not going to focus on tuning. I'm just going to focus on doing some flying. A lot of soft targets today too, by the way. So in case you're wondering, we have a lot of soft targets. Though not so many over where we're going to be flying.
No, not that many.
So we'll see.
Oh my god, look at everyone at the park.
What's going on at the park?
It's just like...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
There's like a whole parade. Alright, well we'll just stay away from that.
Not that many, but it's more than we're used to.
It's enough.
Yeah.
Oh, I want to get some of that gravel footage on this side, because that's the side that's the camera.
That's the camera side.
Yeah, gravel footage.
Oh, look at the chickens.
Chickens? Those are seagulls. I don't know why seagulls are here. You want to maybe try to change your angle of attack? Check it out over there.
Might work. Do we try it?
Yeah, let's try it.
All right, let's try it. Oh, I know what it is. It does have a tape on the back.
But this will actually be a better angle for both of us. Whoa. I don't know what I just fell into, some sort of swamp.
Man, look at those chickens.
It's a lot of chicken.
Oh my god, look at them all in the air.
That's a lot of chicken.
There are a lot of chickens.
There's a lot of chickens. Alright, we're gonna get flying. Alright, see ya. Woo! Wow. Alright. Yeah. So, that was some amazing flying that we did right then and there. We flew it till it was dark. Probably flew it a little too dark. Back to therapy. So, I'll tell you right now, in my head, coming out thinking, all right, I'm just gonna be a little therapeutic. Do some flying just to like get the blood flowing, to clear out your head, and have yourself a good old time. That's a good mindset to come and do a flight with, because you'll see the flight footage in a little bit, but I was feeling really comfortable. I mean, I wasn't really pushing limits. I wasn't really being too crazy, you know, all over the place. But I could feel like things started to fall into a little bit of a groove, which is, you know, an aspect of my flying that I haven't really figured out yet, is getting into like a groove freestyle where you just this and that and that and this and boom, bidi bing, giddy bang. I'm more like, I'm doing this. And now I do that. And here comes this. So I was feeling more fluidy this time around. How about you? What's your jam?
I think I finally felt flow, where I was just doing stuff, because normally I do a trick, I fly away from the trick, and I line myself up for the next time for a perfect trick. Today I just went with whatever I had, and I think it came out amazing. And I'm usually pretty heavy on the sticks. Like, I'll do, like, jerky motions. It's very fluent and flowy today, you know? It wasn't... Yeah.
And I would have to agree with that. Because I was watching you on a couple of your flights on first person. And, yeah. Because you usually are very jerky.
Yeah.
And I can be jerky sometimes, too. I'm trying to get, like, a little flow.
Yeah, it's like a habit. Because when you first start, that's what you are. You know, you're jerky because you're afraid to go upside down for long periods of time or, like, slowly come out of something.
Yeah, it's very true. It's definitely a technique that requires a lot of learning and a lot of practice and a lot of airtime to get it to where you feel comfortable, where, like, the quad is, like, an extension of you versus I'm controlling it. When you're in the moment, it's one thing. When you go back and look at the footage, you could be like, oh my god, this is what I thought was good. So, we'll see when we get home and I put this all together and edit the footage. But, I mean, basically the take-home message here, guys, is that, you know, if you just need to get your mind off some stuff, start flying. If you just happen to find my channel and you're not even really into this thing, you know, go check out, like, a Tiny Whoop or a B-Brain V2 or, you know, any of those little micro guys and just fly it around your room a little bit, you know. It can really help you out. Just getting your mind clear when your mind's on other things, you know. It helps you clear your mind. And gotta get you into the hobby too. That's the other thing. You gotta grow this hobby. We need to keep that forward momentum going. You know, we wanna push it further, grow the hobby, get more people involved. And also, the other thing that's bothering me is this whole, like, negative rap that you get for being, like, I feel like quad flyers are, like, the skateboarders of, like, yesteryear, where it's like, oh, those skateboarders, get out of here, you know? And that's not, you know, that's not what we're here to do. We're here to have fun, you know, enjoy ourselves, respecting the law, respecting traffic laws, making sure we stop at red lights.
Easily could have blew that fast.
I could have, but I didn't.
Like, so. Modify, man. You gotta take the opportunity.
Yeah, that's true. But anyway, I wanna, you know, you gotta be respectful. You gotta follow the law, follow the rules. And, you know, play it safe, man. You know, don't be flying something you don't know how to fly and end up hurting someone.
And I would agree with that, because these so-called drones people buy, you can go to Toys R Us and get for like $25 and give it to your 9-year-old kid. And I look 9, but I'm not. And they just fly these things. Some people crash them into the White House, you know, and it gives drones a bad vibe. People don't like them anymore.
It's true. And you don't want to have that kind of reputation. Because the worse the reputation that we get for this hobby, the more that they're gonna maybe, you know, shut it down. You know, there'll be places that pass more laws and stuff that you can't fly. Get out there, get your therapy on. Do it safe and be respectful of others around you. If you go to a park and you show up like, you know, today, like we were at the park, there's a lot of people around. We always made sure to stay clear of the people. You don't want to be buzzing around people's heads because they're gonna get worried. You know, everyone was very comfortable with us being there, because we weren't being obnoxious. And we even had some people come up to us with some children, and they were like basically just sitting with us and watching us fly and stuff. And you want to be very friendly, you want to be very polite, and you want to be very courteous. But you also want to make sure everything's safe. So if you see someone going somewhere they shouldn't, you let them know. And when you're flying, be respectful of other people's space. You know, if you see that there's some children playing in the field, don't fly over there. Whoa! That was like a meteor strike.
Your lid thing.
Whoa!
Really?
Whoa. That's pretty.
Wow, that is intense lighting there. You could still fly if you had your nighttime on.
I could. I gotta finish building it or rebuilding it. It's just like keep doing other things. Like today, I'm gonna edit this video now, so now I'm not gonna build it tonight. You know?
Yeah. I'm gonna download my footage.
Speaking of footage, peace.